Libby's Movie Hat. I'm your host, Libby Hat, along with Kevin E.
Hey, Libby, how are you? Happy Friday.
Good. You too, my wonderful producer and co-host. We have a lot of fun together.
We sure do, and it's my favorite time of the year.
Yes. Oh, I know. Halloween horror film time.
October. I love it.
I've been watching pulling on Netflix, just trying to find any good horror movies. Not too many good ones on Netflix.
Netflix is hard to find. But you know, if we have some time at the end of the show today, I can definitely point people in the right direction of some good horror films that are on Netflix as well as HBO Go. And even some free ones you can catch coming out.
Okay, good.
If you don't have Netflix or HBO.
Yes, because, I know, it's so much fun. But some of them are just so corny. Yeah, we'll chat about that at the end. But there aren't a lot. The few movies that are coming out this weekend, I haven't had the opportunity to see. But I did see, and I briefly talked about it last week, Victoria and Abdul. It got 68% on Rotten Tomatoes. And it's about... I think I talked to you about it, Kevin. We talked briefly about it last week.
I think we touched on it a little, but you weren't able to go in depth at all.
But I really liked it. It stars Judi Dench, Academy Award winning Judi Dench, and she plays Queen Victoria later in her life. And basically he's a clerk from India. You know, she was, I guess, she's the head of India or prime minister. I don't know what you call yourself when you're the Queen of England, but you're overseeing.
Right.
I don't know.
I'm not sure.
Something royal.
Sorry. Yeah.
But
Something regal.
But she strikes up. He comes over for the Queen's Jubilee to bring her something from India. This clerk, Abdul Karim, was his name in real life. This is a true story. And he strikes up this wonderful friendship with Queen Victoria. And through his eyes, she sees a changing world and helps to understand India better since she's reigns over it. It's, you know, it just was a good relationship. And a lot of people didn't know about this relationship with this basically servant that she had that she ended up practically knighting because none of the royal family really liked their friendship and
right.
didn't kind of kept it hidden. And there were some journals he had kept about it and they were found and published. And that's how this movie came about.
That's actually really, I mean, that's a good background story. Not a lot of films have that, an origin story like that.
Right, yes, and it's really good. The guy who directed, Stephen Frears, British guy.
I'm not.
Well, he did Florence Foster Jenkins with Meryl Streep.
Oh, okay.
The Queen. He did High Fidelity years ago. I think that'd be a movie you would have seen.
I love that movie with Jack Black and John Cusack.
Yes.
Yeah, it's a great movie.
He did Mary Riley with Julia Roberts years ago about Jack the Ripper, which was an okay movie. And his first film was in 1968. So this director's been around a long time. He's
definitely
very good. He's probably most well known for Florence Foster Jenkins and The Queen, but I highly recommend it. And it's probably not going to be out a lot longer. So,
and this is one of those where you got to kind of go to your Angelica Magnolia.
Angelica is where it's playing at an art house kind of theater. But I talked all about it and we didn't show a trailer. Do we have one? We may not.
For Victoria and Abdul?
Yes.
We absolutely do.
Good.
You want to go ahead and roll it?
Sure. Thanks.
I'm 81 years of age and have almost a billion citizens. I've been in office 62 years, making me the longest serving monarch in history. Have we finished?
Abdul, you will travel to England, to the royal household. You will present the Queen with a ceremonial coin.
Whatever you do, you must not look at Her Majesty.
There's a famine in India.
Prime Minister, you really are terribly depressing.
Yes.
Jillian, Your Majesty.
I suddenly feel a great deal better.
She has requested Mr. Karim be her personal footman.
How do you like your Scottish costumes?
They're very scratchy.
Everything in Scotland is scratchy.
What can they be talking about?
What is a mango?
The queen of fruit.
I would like a mango.
They only grow in India.
Well, I'm Empress of India. So have one cent. No one really knows what it's like to be queen.
Mother!
Are you spying on me? Everyone I've loved has died, and I just go on and on. What is the point?
So is, Your Majesty. We are here for a greater purpose.
You are a servant no longer. You will teach me Urdu and the Quran.
You've upset the order of everything.
Not this Indian peasant. Or we will have you certified insane.
Queen of England, Empress of India. Abdul's risen on his own merits. Now he is my friend. I haven't been as happy as this for years.
A little surprise.
What is it?
A mango, Your Majesty.
It's off. Sir Henry, this mango is off.
Oh my gosh, I had chills.
That was a really good trailer.
It's really a good movie.
So having already seen it, that trailer really kind of hits closer to home for you. You can able to.
And she was the Empress of India. That's right. She was the Queen of England, the Empress of India. But because, you know, the Indians didn't like being taken over by, obviously, England.
And, right.
It was a very sweet movie. I highly recommend it. And I think she'll be nominated for an Academy Award.
You could never go wrong with a Judi Dench performance. They're always fantastic. And something that I always marvel at, she's one of those actors or actresses kind of like Michael Caine to me, mm-hmm. where they've looked the same my entire life. Exactly. I don't know how that's possible. I remember her being kind of an older woman in, say, you know, GoldenEye back in 1995.
James Bond. M.
Yes.
She was M, which I loved.
Yes. And I mean, up until as recently as Skyfall, only, you know, mm-hmm. 4 or 5 years ago. And mm-hmm. still, every bit is good. Still looks the same to me, acts the same. She's just a very well-rounded performer,
actress.
In my opinion.
In this film, they, you know, the Queen Victoria was very overweight, and they obviously made her look a lot heavier.
Yeah, because she was saying that in the trailer, but she didn't look very heavy to me.
I know. They made her look heavy. But should we give it? I'm going to say highly popcorn worthy.
You're going to go highly popcorn. You're not going to go Oscar for this.
No, I think she'll be nominated, but I don't think the film will be. See it. So that was fun. I love him. You're a guy, but I'm over here like when I see a performance like that, I had chills.
Yeah, no, I get that all the time with
you. Do? Okay.
Oh, definitely.
When I know something's beautiful. Can you hear me? My little speakers like in between my
pearls? I can only hear when you were moving them around. Okay. But I think you're okay now.
I'm good now. Okay.
I'll give you a heads up if you're cracking anymore.
Okay, so Kevin, you saw what else? Oh, Happy Death Day.
Happy Death Day.
And it got 67% on Rotten Tomatoes.
Yes.
Which is good.
It's pretty
okay.
good. It's not quite certified fresh, but it is in the fresh region. You know, it's not mm-hmm. rotten. And this kind of plays into what you and I have been talking about ever since we started doing the show, how I always say the horror films that get pretty good reviews are always the ones I tend to think are kind of dumb, which sort of plays into this one. The premise is okay. It reminds me of Edge of Tomorrow with Tom Cruise. If you can remember that film.
Yeah, well, the same day, like Groundhog Day almost.
And Groundhog Day as well.
But a horror
version. Someone's reliving the exact same day, whether they die or whatever. With hers, of course, she dies every day, and essentially she's trying to track down her killer so that she can prevent herself from ever being killed.
Murdered.
Yes.
But whenever they do films like that, I get people, they say Groundhog Day is one of the best films, the comedies of all time. And I'm like, it kind of bored me. They kept showing the thing over.
It's
Did
maddening.
This bore you?
I think it's maddening.
I mean, was it maddening to you?
It's a little bit of both. I mean, the characters are okay. I'm not going to call the main character a horrible actress. I'm not going to say she's any kind of a prodigy either. Mm-hmm. But not only did it kind of anger me with the monotonous, repetitive kind of stuff, but it was annoying. It is, in my opinion, annoying on so many levels. The characters, the killing, the style, the story, the pacing. The pacing's okay. I mean, it goes by quick, as most horror films do. But I was just in no way taken with this film. And I watch a lot of scary movies. Mm-hmm. And there are times, it's rare, but I'll turn one on and maybe 15 or 20 minutes in, I'll say, I'm not really feeling this, and I'll turn it off.
Right.
If this had been one of those movies that I was watching at home,
off.
Absolutely would have turned it off.
Oh, okay.
I would have bailed on it.
Yeah, then
it's just not for me.
Then I won't go see it.
If you're one who that title strikes you as being like, ooh, that's kind of clever and modern and edgy, and mm-hmm. you think, maybe I want to see this, maybe you would like it. Maybe you do want to go see it. I saw the trailer for that movie and saw the title and said, this looks really, really dumb, and that's exactly the reaction I had going into it. So, I mean, after I saw it. So maybe that's because I was predisposed to not like it. I don't know. Either way, it was not for me.
It's a no-go.
It was obnoxious. I'm not in the mood. It's definitely not scary. The premise is interesting. It could have been good. It's one of those films where I look at it and there have been films where I say, this premise is horrible. It's going to be bad, like The Purge. And then I saw it and it's great.
Yes.
Did not have this reaction there.
Were there any star names in it? I don't think so. Didn't really have anybody.
No, it's a no name, and typically that's a good direction to go for a horror film when you have, you know, movies like Saw, where not a lot of fame. Yeah,
there was one person.
Well, Danny Glover is in there, you know.
It's gonna make some money, which is kind of maddening because it's not a, as you're saying, it's not a great film.
It appeals to a younger crowd. Mm-hmm. It's in theaters around Halloween time. Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's. I think it definitely will be successful. Oh, and of course, it's a PG-13 film, so the violence isn't as good. Yes, I think younger people will flock to it in droves and probably enjoy it. It's just not for me.
Wait, did you just hear what you said? The violence isn't as good.
Well, yeah.
That's pretty funny. Okay, wait a minute. I gotta think about that. But I get it.
It's true. You don't.
It makes it better.
Yeah.
Like, what was? It was an R.
Yeah, it is.
And
an
it
R.
needed to be an R.
It needed to be an R.
But that was a kind of a concern because, you know, people were asking me, can my middle school child see it? And I'm like, yeah, they kind of can.
Right.
So, I mean...
Yeah, and it's not excessively gory.
No, but yeah, it kind of... Yeah. It's a hard call. That's funny.
A good example I use is kind of a campy, mm-hmm. sticky horror film is Scream, but it almost redefined the genre. And if you go back and watch Scream, that very opening scene with Drew Barrymore...
So gory.
It's really brutal.
I had nightmares.
That's an intense scene, and that's what I mean when I say the violence isn't as good. If they had done that in a PG-13 way, it wouldn't have set the tone for the movie to where they can fill in all that camp and stuff and still make it work. It would have set the tone of a cheesy movie from the very beginning. So that's why I think you need that R rating just to set that believability, even if you don't go excessive with it.
Can you believe, like, Scream is probably 20 years old or something?
Because
my son, who's almost 25, he was young.
94, maybe? Something like that?
He was probably, like, 2.
Yeah.
That's weird. Wow. Okay, well, do you have a trailer of that?
I do have a trailer for it, but you want to go ahead and run that?
Sure, why not?
Sure.
I haven't seen a trailer yet, so let's see.
Oh, hey, you're up.
Am I in a dorm room?
Yeah, I folded your pants for you.
Great.
Dude, did you hit that? Oh, what?
Don't charge, it's your birthday. Stop global warming. You sneaky little biatch. Maybe you should switch to water next time. Super helpful. Don't be late to party tonight.
Okay, bye.
Bye. Tree, happy birthday. You scared me.
Yeah.
Look, I know this isn't going to make any sense.
Stop global warming?
I feel like I'm losing my mind.
You sneaky little biatch.
Happy birthday.
I've already lived through this day.
Somebody's going to kill me tonight.
So you can hear now.
Is everything okay?
Shut up! Shut up!
Assuming that I believe any of this is even possible.
Sprinklers? Car alarm?
The way I see it, you have unlimited amount of lives. Unlimited opportunities to solve your own murder.
So I'm supposed to keep dying until I figure out who my killer is?
You want to live to see tomorrow, right? Whoever's killing you knows it's your birthday.
Pretty much the entire school knows it.
These are signs of major trauma. You should be dead.
You relive the same day over and over again. Kind of starts to see who you really are.
I did it! Woo!
All units, we've got a 187.
I don't know.
You kind of see what I'm talking about,
right? Well,
the
trailer, it looked terrible. As the trailer went on, it got better.
Yeah.
The trailer got better. Right, the trailer. The bad guy's mask isn't scary.
It's not scary.
I mean, that's not good.
No.
They need a better, scarier mask. I don't know.
Not into it. And with masks, in my opinion, the simpler, the scarier. You look at the main guy from The Strangers with like the burlap sack over his head, that's creepy.
Very scary.
Spray painted Captain Kirk from Michael Myers, that's creepy.
Yes.
That mask trying too hard.
No. So you're giving it, obviously.
Ooh, you know, this is tough. I don't know how tough, how hard I'm going to be on this movie. I'm not going to go full bag full of kernels because there is some entertainment to be had here, but it's certainly not good. I'm going to say half pint.
Half pint. Okay. Well, there you go. Well, that's not terrible. That, semi-half pop.
Yeah.
Okay, well, I think I may take that off my list. But, you know, you young kids, go see it.
If you saw the scene where the two girls are saying bye to each other, the way they say bye. Bye.
Oh, that, right then I
cringe. That defines the whole film.
Oh, no. No, that, no. No, no. I'm checking that off my list.
If that turns you off, then I promise you're not going to like the rest.
Okay. There's another movie that I was telling you about, and you didn't even know it's out, and Professor Marsden and the Wonder Woman.
That's right. I'm not familiar with this.
And it got 90% on Rotten Tomatoes. It's a true story of Dr. William Marsden, a psychologist and inventor, and it supposedly inspired the iconic super...
The Wonder Woman.
Wonder Woman.
Yeah, I'm in no way familiar with
this. And it's got a great, it has Rebecca Hall and Luke Evans, great actors, 90%. So we got to check that out.
Definitely.
We need to check that out for next week.
In fact, that might be the most fresh thing that's going on right now.
I know. I mean, there is not, the other good movies, well, the Foreigner with Jackie Chan, 68% on Rotten Tomatoes. That looks good to me because they say, I saw him interviewed this morning and he said this is his, you know, he does all those action karate chopping.
All his own stunts, yeah.
Own stunt type things. This is kind of a little bit of a dramatic role. His daughter is blown up by a terrorist bomb and he goes after the bad guys, and that's kind of a dramatic role for him. And it's like his favorite, most dramatic role he's done, he said on an interview I saw.
That's cool. I'm a big Jackie Chan fan.
I am too.
This is almost like his re-emerge, kind of like Liam Neeson with Taken, where in his 50s he comes out and makes another semi-serious but very good, you know, action-type film as an older action hero. I think that's kind of what Jackie Chan's doing, and I think he's going to be successful at it.
Don't you think he's probably close to 60 even?
He's got to be.
Surely he's not doing his stunts, but probably is.
He probably is.
Probably is. But that looked good, and then Marshall looks good, or maybe, I think it's, yeah, Marshall. It's about Supreme Court Justice Thurgood Marshall.
Right.
Kate Hudson's in it. A lot of other good actors. It's about a case he did early on in his career that was the template profile case for starting the NAACP, the Legal Defense Fund.
Mm-hmm.
So, I'm sure it'll be good.
I think so.
So I'll probably go see that. And then Blade Runner's still out, which I haven't seen yet.
You haven't seen?
88% on Rotten Tomatoes.
And I'm not judging you for it, because if you're not a sci-fi enthusiast or Blade Runner enthusiast, it is confusing and weird and very, very long. So.
How long is the runtime? Almost 3 hours, 2.5?
I want to say it's 247, or 2 hours and 47 minutes, something like that.
That's too long for me for science fiction. I think I'm going to pass.
And I will usually even pass on that long.
Mm-hmm.
I would say the closest thing, I mean, I watched 2001. I like that.
Mm-hmm.
The Chris Nolan Batman films I like. They're, I mean, Dark Knight Rises was pushing 3 hours. I don't know if that's sci-fi, but still.
But I like some science fiction. You just have much more of appreciation. You get them. I don't understand. I'm lost a lot of time. My mind just doesn't think that way.
Some people are just wired for sci-fi.
But I do like horror films, like you do. I like dumb ones. I watched one on Netflix last night that was pretty decent. I got to think of the name of it. I wondered if you've seen it. I'll think about it.
If you can describe the premise, I can probably come up with it.
These two guys are they're killing girls and taking pictures of them.
Ooh, that's.
And it has this Indian actor in it that's a photographer reenacting, and the mask in it are real scary. I think it went direct to Netflix.
Will you text me that, though? It sounds like something I would like, though.
I liked it. It was pretty good.
Yeah, that's pretty cool.
And I don't think it has any well-known names except this one Indian actor. Okay, so that's what's kind of coming out now. Oh, real brief thing. I was telling Kevin at the Angelica this month, they're doing Hitchtober, where they show Hitchcock films on Thursday nights. And tonight they're doing Notorious. So it's fun to see. And I think they end the week of Halloween which is on a Tuesday night, with Psycho.
Oh, that's very cool.
So that's fun.
Yeah.
But, you know, I do like Halloween, though. I mean, the actual, I just want to turn the light. I don't want to answer the door. Well, you're in an apartment, I think.
See, it's so funny. My girlfriend always wants to go out on Halloween and go somewhere, like a bar or something, and dress up.
Interesting.
And I don't. What I like to do on Halloween, even at the age of 32, I just like to go over to my parents' house in our suburban neighborhood and hang out there and watch horror films and help decorate the house and hand out candy and that stuff, because that's the feeling of Halloween that I like.
So how do y'all resolve
this? Bar anytime. So last year, we went out and we did that whole thing. And then this year, we're going to my parents' house.
For so you're trading off. That's hilarious. But are you kind of? But you like dressing up.
I do.
See, I don't.
I put a lot into my costumes.
Oh, I'm sure. You need it. My brother Wayne was on one of your shows. He loves dressing up. His birthday is on Halloween.
Oh, that's awesome.
Yes. So he loves it more than any human you've ever seen.
Should invite him out to the burbs. Come hang out.
Oh, he'd love it. He collects now. He has like four of them suits that like have clowns, or one has dollar signs. Anyway, that's been his new thing, is just to wear a complete suit, tie, everything. It's so funny.
That's cool.
But okay, so since Halloween is coming up and you love horror films, tell everybody what you do. You watch a horror film or two or three a night leading up to Halloween.
I do, and this is a little more challenging than people realize, because there's not that many good ones on Netflix that you want to watch. Mm-hmm. And they're kind of hard to find, because if you go to horror section on Netflix and you start scrolling through,
they're
a lot of
good
stuff you never heard of. You maybe find a needle in a haystack every once in a while. So you got to kind of map out what you want to do, which is what I do. There's certain that I have to hit on, and those I'll actually pay to rent. But HBO Go has a lot of good ones, depending on your style. If you just like really bad, campy slashers, you know, go check out Halloween Resurrection streaming right now. It's a terrible Halloween film. But if you just want to watch something kind of dumb and mindless that has Michael Myers in it, check that out.
Is Jamie Lee Curtis in that one?
Very little.
Very little.
And
okay.
I hate that one, because I'm a huge fan of Halloween H2O, which she was in before, which is great Halloween.
I like that one too.
That one's my favorite sequel.
Were they in that school?
Yes, exactly.
Yes, I like
the
that one too.
Private school, yeah.
Yes.
It's really good.
Josh Hartnett, I think, is in
yes,
it.
Yes, exactly. Uh-huh. And Michelle Williams, yeah, that's a good one.
Yeah, Michelle Williams was, that was the beginning of her career.
If you're more of a Freddy fan, they're going to be doing a Freddy marathon on AMC Fear Fest, which will start soon.
Nightmare on Elm Street.
Nightmare on Elm Street. And those aren't all good. The first one's good. The third one's good. And then I really love, and this one's on HBO Go right now, called Wes Craven's New Nightmare.
Mm-hmm.
And it's the last one of his Nightmare trilogy or series. And it's meta, meaning it exists within the world of Freddy Krueger, where the actress who plays the original Nancy ends up actually being haunted by Freddy Krueger. And so Wes Craven is actually in the movie as himself. Robert Englund is in the movie as himself. And it sounds dumb, but the execution is great.
Oh, that sounds good, but
I think it's really good.
The girl that was the original Nancy was such a bad actress, though.
Horrible. And still is bad. And everyone.
She has, like, the flattest tone. You're just like, how did she get cast in that?
She never evolves.
Never.
No.
Never. I had seen Jeepers Creepers. They were doing this one night release, and they premiered it again through Fathom Events at AMC North Park. I think the AMC theaters were putting it out, but you saw Jeepers Creepers.
I did. I was lucky enough to get a screening invite for a video service that you can view online. So I didn't get the movie theater experience per se, but I was able to watch the entire film.
Because this is three, Jeepers Creepers 3.
Jeepers
I had seen
Creepers
one.
Three.
I had not seen two that I remember, but I saw three. So what'd you think? It's compared to one.
Oh, if we're comparing to one, it's not very good.
Yes.
It's not particularly scary. It doesn't look very cool. They seem to put more emphasis into going over the top with the style of kills from the creeper, just making it really ridiculous than making it scary.
I remember I told you during the day they were showing him being killed, and it'd be scarier if they were shown at night.
Another huge
agree?
Problem I had. Way too much of it took place during the day.
Right.
And he doesn't look scary in the daylight. The makeup looks...
Remember I told you that?
I could have done it at home. Yeah.
I was like, his face was like, that's a joke. That's like...
Yeah.
That it wasn't scary. It was so... it just didn't even look like any kind of monster that you would,
if it had been CG, I can understand that, but I think there's really no excuse for it when you're using practical effects. Like, a real movie effects makeup artist did that, and it looked
terrible.
That campy. I'm going to say it maybe is a slight step up from two in terms of creativity. I'll give it that. It's a little better. You get the return of an original star. That kind of helps. But it's not
Wait,
much
the return
better.
Of what original
Gina
star?
Gina Phillips.
Who is she in it?
She is. She plays the same character from the first film.
Is she one of the girls?
Yes, she was. I can't think of the main character's name of the first one, played by Justin Long. She was his sister.
Oh, okay.
And so that's kind of a decent tie-in, but overall, it's not great. If you are able to catch it, rent it on, you know, watch it streaming, maybe do that, but do not waste your time trying to find a screening out there somewhere, because it's just not worth it.
It was silly. There were a couple of cool special effects. Is he a scarecrow that flies? What is he?
Some sort of mythical beast, but there were some cool parts. I mean, there's one where he throws a harpoon and like sort of kebabs two guys against a tree. I'm like, all right, that's kind of cool, but it's not really
for those people that like a body count when they do it. Yeah,
it's not scary, but it's cool. So it's okay.
It's okay. Yeah,
it's okay.
But you were saying on AMC there's a countdown of movies 10 days before Halloween of horror films.
They used to do it the whole month, AMC Fear Fest.
I remember.
And now I think it's only like 10 days.
AMC, I need to find that.
And so they just released the lineup online. Okay. If you go to amctv.com, I went and checked it out, and I was kind of disappointed.
Oh, shoot.
There's a lot of Halloween marathons, which are okay, but the Halloween sequels aren't great. I mean, if you're going to watch bad sequels, the Friday the 13th ones are way more fun, in my opinion. I like all the Scream sequels. Those aren't in there in any way.
Oh.
So it's not a great lineup, but I'm sure I'll still be checking it out.
Oh, I'll check it out. Now, tell me, the Halloween sequels, because I'm a big fan, that was probably one of my scariest movies besides The Shining.
The first Halloween. Last night.
The Shining, which is so good.
Great.
But the Halloween, remember there's that one where it has nothing to do with Michael Myers, but they're in a factory and those pumpkin heads. What was
Halloween 3 Season of the Witch?
What was that?
It was a it's
so bad that sometimes I find myself watching it. It's so bad it's good.
Oh, I almost like it. The music they play in the commercial for the kids with the mask, I get that stuck in my head every year. It's almost like what they did with the Friday the 13th TV series that came out. It had nothing to do with Jason. It was almost just an anthology horror series. That's kind of what they were trying to do with Season of the Witch. Since it's not a Michael Myers movie, it's an anthology film that just relates to Halloween.
So that had nothing to do with Michael Myers.
Nothing to do with Michael Myers
at all.
Yeah, it's about a toy company manufacturing these masks to take over kids' minds. It's like a whole thing, and it's not good.
I know.
It's really
Not good. It's so not good that it's so bad it's good. There is that kind of movie.
True.
That you can't, like Roadhouse with Patrick Swayze.
Exactly.
You cannot stop watching it.
And I have to admit, it's kind of a guilty pleasure. I like Season of the Witch, but after that they scrapped it in Halloween 4, Return of Michael Myers gets back to Michael Myers, but they'll always include Season of the Witch in the marathons. A lot of people skip it. I'll turn it on.
Oh,
I find
I'll
it entertaining,
it.
But
I wondered if you had seen it. That's funny. Well, but so you do that TV that's where you kind of piecemeal your TV together with Roku and all that. Mm-hmm. So how do you find AMC? You find it online to watch?
I have it through Sling TV, which is an app I pay $20 a month, and AMC comes with it. And I love AMC. It's a good channel. Last year, I thought they really dropped the ball on Fear Fest because they kept playing Walking Dead marathons.
Oh,
and it
I
made
don't
me
like that.
Quit trying to cram your horror TV show down everyone's throat and start some scary movies.
Yeah.
This year, they're not doing that, so they have that going. But if you really want to do a horror marathon, you're going to have to go into streaming and not a cable channel because they just don't really have it going on.
They don't. So, but how do you, does that work out price-wise the same or better if you piecemeal your own TV together?
Oh, way cheaper.
Because my son's doing that too, and I'm like, I don't know. But I like turning the TV on and something always being on.
Yeah, I do too. I mean, that's something I miss.
Are you missing it?
You can kind of get that experience with Sling, meaning you can jump in on something.
Okay.
But it's not quite the same where you turn your TV on, there's automatically something there. But
so many people, some people my even age are doing this. I really count on the news. I like my news that way. Certain, you know, my husband and I watch Fox. There's just certain, you know, news things. I don't know.
No, it makes sense. It's something that it was a learning curve for me because I've loved having cable my whole life. So it's something to get used to.
You're learning. My husband's really old school, though. He can hardly even tape things. So it's funny. He's old school. Okay, well, we will talk about more horror films. I guess we're done.
We are done.
Thanks for joining us. We're here every Friday. And we're also brought to you by Fanprint, fanprint.com for your T-shirt needs. But now go enjoy the movies. We'll be right back.